GDB is the standard debugger for C code, but its terminal interface is unwieldy. VS Code provides an intuitive interface for GDB, also integrating the ability to edit your code as you find issues. VS Code and GDB are both available on Windows, Linux, and Mac. I don't have a modern Mac, so I can't help you there, but I use this setup on both Windows and Linux. GDB is part of MinGW on Windows, and I've got a tutorial on how to install that in the description and comments. I'll briefly show you how to install VS Code on Windows. Visit code.visualstudio.com. Download the 64-bit user or system installer. I prefer system. Then run through it like any normal installation. If you want an installation tutorial for Linux, let me know. VS Code is designed to guide you through how to use it with various prompts and suggestions. The first prompt is to install a color theme. I like GitHub Dark. If you create or open a .c file, VS Code will recommend some C programming extensions. The C++ extension is used for IntelliSense and debugging support. Here's a simple C program. We can automatically build this file and debug it by opening the Run, Start Debugging menu. VS Code asks what debugger to use, and if you've got MinGW installed as per my tutorial, GDB will appear as an option. Then VS Code needs a build configuration. I always use GCC, but if you use Clang, I'm sure it's compatible with GDB debugging. Now our C file is being built per the default configuration, and then opened in GDB to run and debug. If we click back to the Terminal tab, we can see the output of our program as it was run within GDB. That didn't look too exciting, but we now have access to various debugging tools. If you click in this empty area left of your code, you can add breakpoints which will pause your program during debugging. When we debug again, as expected, the program pauses here so we can examine variables, step through the code line by line, and so on. If your program seg faults, you'll get a stack trace and get shown where in your code the fault happened. There are several more debugging features, but I'll leave it to you to explore the options as you debug your own code. Over here is the File Browser tab. We can open a folder as the base of our project and get prompted to trust the folder to execute code within it. So far, we've just been building whatever C file is open at the moment, but usually you want to run a specific build script for your project. I like to use a build.bat file like so, adding -gGDB to ensure debug information is compiled specifically for GDB. We can get VS Code to run this build script by opening Terminal, Configure Default Build Task. I want to build with GCC. This creates a tasks.json file in the .vscode directory, with a standard GCC build task. Here I'm editing the task so that it will simply execute my build.bat script. Now Terminal Run Build Task will run this task, executing the build script. The F5 key runs the default debugging configuration, and I like to have that automatically run my build task before debugging. Make sure to have a C file as the active file in VS Code, then hit Run, Add Configuration, and select C++ GDB. This creates a launch.json file in .vs code, but for some reason doesn't actually add a configuration until we try again. Now we can select C++ GDB launch to use that template. We need to tell it what program to debug. In my case, that's a.exe within the workspace folder. The current working directory should be the workspace folder too. We need to fill in the path to GDB. If you followed my installation tutorial, that will be c, mingw64, bin, gdb.exe. Finally, I'm going to add a pre-launch task using the label of my build task, so that my program will be rebuilt whenever I hit F5 to debug. That should be enough to get you started with debugging your C programs. I invite you to discuss different configuration options, debugging features, and any other tips you may find relating to VS Code and GDB in the comments. Cheers!